Well, sometimes any team is only good as its seniors, Coach, and you've got a guy that's been around the block for quite some time now, and Zam Fredrick, one of the seniors on this team, one of the leading scorers, and certainly a guy you're going to depend on a lot for points throughout this season.
Well, Zam's a guy, as you mentioned, that is a fifth-year senior with transferring back to South Carolina from Georgia Tech and brings us a great deal of experience and can score the basketball. And the thing we've been encouraged by is has really focused on trying to expand his game and become a rebounder from the wing position and do a better job of taking care of the basketball. So we've really seen some growth in him as a player.
Let's find out some more now about the senior out of St. Matthews, South Carolina, Zam Fredrick.
Everyone was saying they was happy that I was back and why didn't I come in the beginning, and it was just a welcoming experience because I was back home. Maybe we could start again. I had a target on my back since I started playing in eighth grade. So I was hearing chants like Daddy's boy and I only made the team because he's my father and stuff like that. So it's always been a target. I've always been under the microscope. Just growing up trying to live up to what he did and trying to find myself at the same time, you know, growing up in his shadow. So to say, it's been tough, but it made me into the person I am. He the first person I call after the game to tell him what happened and how I felt or what he felt and the things that I need to do or work on. Only when I ask him though. He don't push his way into it. My basketball life, but I always want to know what he thinks. Oh, this tattoo of my son, it's a 5-month photo. He's a big inspiration, you know. I felt like when he came into this world, I had a responsibility. And I'm going to do whatever it takes, you know, to make sure that he lives a good life. And I'm out there struggling. Or feeling like I'm not doing what I'm supposed to. I just look to my show. You might see me rub his face a couple of times, let him know that he got to eat. Regardless of how I feel about anything, he has to eat. And I'm going to provide for him. All your social stuff get cut off. As far as hanging with the fellas and going out a lot and doing things like that, you got to prioritize. My son, he comes before all that. I grew up in the system, so it's normal. You know, running, gun, trapping, and pressing, getting as many opportunities as you can, forcing the tempo, you know, just making people uncomfortable. That's just how I grew up playing. That's the first way I learned how to play the game. And Coach Horn coming here, I just feel like it's a blessing to be able to play the game the way I was taught to play it, and I don't think there's no other way to play the game. My personal goal is for us to get 20 wins again in the tournament. But if we do that, then I'll be able to achieve any individual goal that I have set for myself. I don't just go out and say, I got to do this, I got to do that. First of all, we got to win. If we don't win, nobody's talking to you. You're not getting any looks.
Stick around. We have highlights from the Furman game coming up on the Darrin Horn Show next.